वैदिक मैथमेटिक्स इंट्रोडक्शन। वैदिक मैथमेटिक्स इज द एंशियंट सिस्टम ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स विच वॉज रीडिस्कवर्ड अर्ली लास्ट सेंचुरी बाय श्री भारती कृष्ण तीर्थ जी। द संस्कृत वर्ड वेदा मीन्स नॉलेज। द वेदाज आर एंशियंट राइटिंग्स हुज डेट इज डिस्प्यूटेड बट विच डेट फ्रॉम एटलीस्ट सेवरल सेंचुरीज BC। अकॉर्डिंग टू इंडियन ट्रेडिशन द content of the Vedas was known long before writing was invented and was freely available to everyone. It was passed on by word of mouth. The writings called the Vedas consist of a huge number of documents, and these have recently been shown to be highly structured, both within themselves and in relation to each other. Subjects covered in the Vedas include grammar, astronomy, architecture, psychology, philosophy, archery, etc., etc. 100 years ago, Sanskrit scholars were translating the Vedic documents and were surprised at the depth and breadth of knowledge contained in them. But some documents headed Ganita Sutras, which means mathematics, could not be interpreted by them in terms of mathematics. One verse, for example, said, "In the reign of King Kamse, famine, pestilence, and unsanitary conditions prevailed." This is not mathematics, they said, but nonsense. Bharati Krishna was born in 1884 and died in 1960. He was a brilliant student, obtaining the highest honors in all the subjects he studied, including Sanskrit, philosophy, English, mathematics, history, and science. When he heard what the European scholars were saying about the parts of the Vedas which were supposed to contain mathematics, he resolved to study the documents and find their meaning. Between 1911 and 1918, he was able to reconstruct the ancient system of mathematics, which we now call Vedic mathematics. He wrote 16 books expounding this system, but unfortunately these have been lost. And when the loss was confirmed in 1958, Bharati Krishna wrote a single introductory book entitled Vedic Mathematics. This is currently available and is a bestseller. My teacher, Mr. Kenneth Williams, came across the book Vedic Mathematics in 1971 and has been developing the content of that book and applying the system in other areas not covered by Bharati Krishna since then. Anything in my videos which is not in Vedic Mathematics, I have learned from Mr. Kenneth Williams. Sir Kenneth has produced several books and DVDs and has been invited to many countries around the world to give seminars and courses. For a full detail of any of his books and DVDs, please visit www.vedicmaths.org. You will find the courses there for teachers and students as well. There are many special aspects and features of Vedic mathematics which are better discussed as we go along rather than now, because you will need to see the system in action to appreciate it fully. But the main points for now are: the system rediscovered by Bharati Krishna is based on 16 formulae and some sub-formulae. These sutras are given in word form, for example, by one more than the one before, and vertically and crosswise. The sutras can be related to natural mental functions such as completing a whole, noticing analogies, generalization, and so on. Not only does the system give many striking general and special methods previously unknown to modern mathematics, but it is far more coherent and integrated as a system. Number three, Vedic mathematics is a system of mental mathematics. Many of the Vedic methods are new, simple and striking. They are also beautifully interrelated, so that division, for example, can be seen as an easy reversal of the simple multiplication method. This is in complete contrast to the modern system. Because the Vedic methods are so different to the conventional methods, and also to gain familiarity with the Vedic system, it is best to practice the techniques as you go along. Thank you very much.